What's up with the what's ups? Today on this episode of Mayhem and Motorcycles, we're gonna go over some chopper EDC everyday carry. This episode is sponsored by CJRB Culture. So about a month ago, CJRB's reached out to us and asked if we would like to do a test and review of one of their knives.
Of course, you know, I said, yeah. And well, I've actually been using this for the past 2 weeks, and check it out.
So, once receiving the package, it came in this nice little silky box. Then once open, then it came in this nice little nylon bag, which you could probably use for your EDC. Got some nice felt backing, two pockets, and then the mother huncha. So this is the Echo Jade. ARRP9M, the Ryan Lacona design. So, I'm gonna be frank, I've never really done a knife review. You know, it's been in my pocket since I got it. But it's so pretty, I really haven't used it for things at work. So much so that it made me start carrying this one to use at work, because it's just a piece of junk that I don't mind getting dirty or messing up. Which oddly enough made me realize I had stopped carrying a knife altogether. So usually I got a fixed blade and a holster on a belt, but I had stopped tucking in my shirts and wearing nylon belts, so I had stopped using bigger knives. So about the same time that this showed up, I was having issues with my wallet. Being just a small minimalist wallet, you know, I didn't really have room for anything really at all. Then I lost my license twice because they just fall out. So I ended up getting a new wallet, and it's been over 5 years that I've even had a wallet, a full-size wallet with the chain. So getting used to having this on all the time has just been what I'm dealing with right now. But it gives me the opportunity to have everything I need and more. This is just my coin. I don't know if any of y'all have challenge coins, but I give these out to friends and such. This one is actually 1 troy ounce of fine silver coin. So far, it has been a lifesaver. These really don't have space for anything. So the chain came with it. Then this is just Travax keychain extension with the dice keychain. As well, one thing I always do have is my flashlight and my lighter. So I found this while going through the interwebs. It's by Hide and Drink. So it's a wax canvas and leather multi-tool bag. So as you see it now, everything is pretty good and stable. Nothing really slides out. The bigger knife, this is a Milwaukee's Hardline series of knives. This is my second one just like this. One I've used for work so much that just the handle is all ugly, and I wanted one for while I was riding. Only thing is the belt issue again. And by belt issue, I don't use thick leather belts anymore because I have Vans nylon belts. So they tug on the belt. But my pants back pockets are always enough room for everything. So I'll go through everything I have in here. So as y'all saw, was a knife. So I'll pull up the knife as it is with its sheath. And then what came out with that was just a snap-on flathead screwdriver with the magnet at the end. These are worth their weight in gold. Ask any mechanic. These are probably their number one multi-tool in the mechanic shop. Then my flashlight. This is my second one I've gone through in about 5 years. It's just AAA battery. It's 100 lumens. It's got a rubber end, and I have no issues with it. Then my fastback razor, which I'm pretty sure many of y'all have already as well. That's that. And then a spare lighter. Gotta have them. All right. So that leaves you with your three little pockets on the front. You know, one major one in the middle. And then in the back, we got the zipper pocket. So in the back, I have a Prism Supply push rod adjusting tool. Doubles as a bottle opener as well. Bottle opener for just a regular bottle opener. And then this little pouch I found a long time ago and figured I will just utilize it in the little space, which it has a little nail clipper. And then built inside the leather is just a little blade. A nail pick, flathead scraper, and another bottle opener. I just thought it was pretty cool because it's all made in this little leather pouch and it fits perfect in there. And then I think last is just a spark plug gapper. I have to make sure I have one of these on me at all times because these suckers get lost and you wouldn't believe how bad it sucks to need it and not have them. Okay, this is everything I keep in my back pockets, and as surprisingly as much as it looks like and what you would probably think probably weighs a lot, it actually doesn't. It doesn't pull my pants down with the type of belt I do wear. It hasn't gotten the way yet of sitting, and so far everything but these two have been used more than once a day. Then to put everything back in is really very, very easy. I will say that when I first got it, it was hard to put everything in because the leather and the wax canvas wasn't stretched yet. And the way things go in kind of forms against each other just because of the way the material is made. And I've put everything in and out enough times to know exactly how it has to fit in my butt without it giving me a sciatic nerve. Because I did do that once. Back pockets. Alright, now we'll go to the front. Now I've already showed you two items that I keep in my pockets. And these I keep in my right pocket. If you know what this is a dugout. I keep this one in my left pocket with its lighter. Then, just on my keys, I don't remember where I got this. I believe it was maybe eBay or Amazon, but I've had this for about 15 years and it's still going strong. So for my keychain, I have a Leatherman Micro. So it has a ruler up to 4 inches. It's got a really awesome pair of scissors that cuts really awesomely. Then on one side, it's just a knife, flathead, no pick and file. And the other side, small flathead, bottle opener, another flathead or a pry bar, and then some tweezers. I've had this one for about 15 years also, and in 15 years I've probably only used it maybe 3 times. For reals. Then just on here is just a 511 EDC light. I've had this one for about going on 1.5, 2 years. And tell you the truth, I always end up going to this one before this one. Then as far as the coolest gadget I have seen so far, which I know you guys are going to say, what the heck? It's a DeWalt Bluetooth wearable speaker. If Milwaukee had it, I would have got it. I'm not trying to jump shit, but DeWalt actually has something I like. Now, music, for me and my life, is a very big thing. So, I use it while I'm riding. It's loud enough to be enjoyable at highway speeds at about 60 and up. Depending on what song it is, it's a little hard to make out. But what I do is I wear it on the inside of my helmet. So, I do it where the speaker is facing the inside, or facing my face. I put it on my chin strap, under the pad, and I push it as far as I can. So when I do strap myself in, it echoes inside the helmet and it sounds pretty good. You don't really see it. It doesn't really bother, or it doesn't bother my neck or my jaw when I'm turning, looking up. As well as the other features on it, it does answer phone calls. You cycle through the tunes by double tapping on plus or the minus. And then of course, volume up is all the way is plus, volume down is down. And then to turn it on, you just hold it.
Power on, battery high, your device is connected.
That fast. Before it even blinked 3 times, it was already connected. So I'll go ahead and give you an example of how loud it is. I don't know how good an example is through the phone. So this is on loud. So, to give you an idea of how loud it was, and that's it. So there it is. Also, you can either use a clip to attach it to you. It has a magnet, so you can stick it to a metal surface. Or, you can actually stick it to your shirt, clip it from the back, and use the magnet to attach it to your clothing instead of the clip. It comes with an extra magnet in case you lose one. And if you like listening to music, here it is. Now don't get me wrong, you know, there's a lot of y'all that don't like listening to music while you ride. That's fine. But it's loud enough to use while you're out camping, around a campfire, or when you're sitting around family and friends, drinking a cold one, and talking to Samson. So, that's my chopper, EDC. If y'all have any cool ideas of what y'all keep, drop it down in the comments. Well, that's it for this episode of Made My Motorcycles. If you're digging this content, do us a favor. Help us out by liking and subscribing. Until then, see you on the flip side.
Every day, you know you have made it when it has on you.